This portion is brought to you by...
Ang Team Thunderbird, kasama ang Bakbaka na, ay lumipad patungong Amerika para dalawin ang mga iniidolong American breeders. Atin pong kilatisin ang kanilang mga alaga at alamin ang history ng kanilang mga bloodlines para makatulong sa ating breeding program. Dito po sa Thunderbird US Game Fowl Tour. Andito tayo sa US Game Fowl Tour. Today, we found a very, very practical breeder na marami tayong matututunang mga style. Eddie Boy, pakilala mo na muna at ako'y nagiinit.
Ang bisita natin, si James Merrill. Good morning, yeah. James. Thanks a lot, man.
Hello, everybody in the Philippines. My wife is Filipino, and she'll be coming back over there in a month or two to visit everybody. So
she's a Cebuana. I met her.
Yes.
Any Cebuana word that you know?
I don't know any. I'm just a dumb Okie.
How about Pistigiapon?
Oh, I know like the chicken fights, I know a few words like cario and stuff like that, handling stuff, but just practical language, I don't know anything.
Talking about practical, I saw a lot of nice things here that I will adopt in my farm. It's very difficult to have cages, ano, yung mga holding pens, yung mga multi-purpose pens. Kung tawagin ko, mga 5x5s. Ang problema, yung pinto eh. Kumisan, gagamitan mo ng alambre, napuputol.
At yung nabibili dito, kung meron mang seradura, mahirap.
Oh, yung hinges.
Oh, yung hinges na mahirap.
You don't have no hinges, no latches. You just drop it in.
You just drop it in like what we do with our...
See, like these doors here, I put the latches, just a board to turn over and a screw to stop them, hold them. They can't go no further once you turn them over there. And just everything practical. Mm-hmm. When you're getting a whole bunch of stuff, it gets pretty expensive. And you can cut a lot of the cost with that.
Did you see the bamboo holding pens that we have?
I've seen those in the books, yes. Uh-huh. And I've seen them at places
in,
there.
In the Philippines, we use this.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, pero yung sa atin, maliliit. Ito yung malalaki.
Ito yung malaki, inadapt niya.
Inadapt niya.
Kaya yung buong pinto, pag sinaksak mo, tinaas mong ganon, wala nang kawala.
Wala nang kawala. Hindi kaya itulak ng manok.
Isa lang ang problema nito. Pagka kasi kami nag-aalaga ng manok, pagka ginom mo yung kawayan, pinatong mo sa ibabaw, umisa nawawala. Sa bagay ito, mahirap mawala ito. Malaki eh. Tsaka alam mo, partner, nagpunta kami doon sa kanyang fly pens, inside fly pens. And then,
binatasan niya.
Meron siyang butas, there's a hole at the bottom. You can lift the lid, yung gate, and then the chicken will go out and sun himself.
Yeah, and have some green.
And it would be easy.
Yeah, you can just fix it where they can go in, or damp weather, you leave them inside and just let them out on the sunny days. Mm-hmm. Especially when you're moving them to, if you're going to take them, you know, to the fights, move them. They're easy to catch that way in there, get them out and stuff.
They're very easy to catch.
Napuna mo ba, partner, yung extension na nilagay sa labas? Nabubuksan sa ibabaw?
Nabubuksan pa sa ibabaw. Doon siya nanguhuli. Kasi pag pumasok ko sa fly pen, mga kaibigan, lalo na kung wild yung manok, or it's a manshy, or if it's a mean, or man fighter, then you'll have a lot of problems, you know.
From a small pen.
Mm-hmm. So you open the door, and then he goes out, close it.
Close the door from either side, from the small pen side outside or the inside.
And then you can catch it.
Yeah.
Easy.
Very practical.
Yeah, I noticed that meron po siyang mga hen house bawat isang brood pen. And in each hen house, they have nests.
Then
you can go at the back.
Yeah, and open the lid and get the eggs with the hinges on the door.
Without getting inside.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you get inside, the hens will be wild. Flying, they'll be flying.
And you get in there, the hens fly, the rooster wants to hit you, he gets mean and stuff. You can just collect the eggs and don't have to go inside.
And the hens will get agitated. They might not lay eggs.
Very practical, no?
Yeah.
Pero the gist of our trip over here and to talk to you is to see what kind of birds we have here that we might be able to get or buy for the Philippine scenario.
Basically, if people like, you know, the cured stuff on them, what type chickens they want, I know about all the big timers. I can get about any chickens, and If somebody wanted a specific chicken, I can raise them chickens for them.
Uh-huh. Like what do we have here right now?
I've got yellow-legged Stewart hatch. I got sweaters from Stancil. I got Larry Romero's hatch and grays, and I got a few of Stancil's hatches. And then I got roundheads. And did you ever hear of Bud Johns? They won international over there with his chickens. Somebody did it from here out of McAllister. He had the Albanys. Well, I've got those Albanys in.
They won the islands?
Yes, oh. The international in the Philippines.
Oh, in the Philippines, the World International Cup.
1 year with them.
Mm-hmm.
You haven't mentioned my favorite.
The white roosters. They come from H.I. Allen. I got some white cocks, and I bred them to Murphy white hackle hens, and they come white. And then I got an A-seal cock bred to the white Mac hens. They're not Mac White's chickens. They're white Macs, an old breed of white chickens with speckles.
So it's a different Max.
It's an old breed that come out like the white hackles and stuff when they come out of England and Ireland. It's a breed of chickens that come out way back like that. Mm-hmm. Old breed of chickens.
Ito mga bakbakan yung mga puti na kung tawagin natin angat sarado.
Decandado.
Na, they'll just wait for you and go up to you vertically.
And they come from Ireland, no? The white ones?
England or Ireland. All the chickens here eventually come from England and Ireland. Mm-hmm. And that's where they originated out of here in the United States.
Oh, yeah. We have a friend, Randy Heron. His fowl he inherited from his grandpa was also from Ireland, according to the dad. So these really are here, and they're still authentic, and they're still winning.
Yeah,
win.
They come in here basically in the 17th, 18th century, 100, from England and Ireland. Come over here, all the lords over there, and everybody, you know, it was royalty over there. Sort of like in the Philippines, the mayors and the bigger people that fight chickens.
The governors, yeah.
The governors. Yeah, they're sort of like that, and they brought the chickens in here, and then for years, everybody didn't have the good chickens, only the people with money, and that broke loose in about 1940. Everybody started getting chickens. They started selling more, but before, the good chickens, they didn't sell.
I see.
Just in case somebody would be interested to buy roosters from you, where can they get in touch with you?
My phone number is 405-225-8261.
Ayan po mga kabakbakan mula po dito sa Holdenville, Oklahoma, sa farm po ng isang magaling, praktikal, at mahuhusay ang manok. Sa Sweater Game Farm ni ganoong James Merrill. Bakbakana!